History is just a fragment of reality, an extract of a plot told from a subjective point of view. In this process, there are extracts that are left out, but it happens that these parts are disconnected. This triggers the question, can we put together these separate parts? Can we connect what is isolated? This brief story is just a part of my life. Everything starts when I graduated from high school in 1998 in Buenos Aires, Argentina, and I started studying mechanical engineering at university the following year. At that moment, what seemed to be settled and organized started falling apart. It was a moment of crisis for me, overwhelmed with many queries. This situation bears resemblance with how science has established itself. As it felt omnipotent, it ended up colliding with the implacable uncertainty of reality and with the fragile nature that tried to rule.
The main cause of environmental crisis to me is greed of people, of industries, of nations overall. We're always wanting more and more of whatever we have. And we have exploited the world and the resource in it without noticing it because we had other mentalities and our focus was mainly financial. We wanted to improve our status or the countries wanted to develop in higher ways. And humanity forgot about the rest. They forgot about what was surrounding us. And then now that we're seeing the effects, we're all pretty worried and thinking, what should we do?
That growth means growth in GDP, growth in income of the people, and the traditional economics has not really captured the environmental losses which we make during that progress.
I took up different courses, but the feeling of uncertainty was still present. This anxiety of not knowing pervaded until years later I came across environmental sciences. A course with an interdisciplinary approach over a complex field, such as the environment, has given me the opportunity of choosing many integrated sciences.
Environment is a very small word, but it has a lot of meaning. Already, every single effect on it, and we are also affected by it.
Environment has always been a hard thing for me to define, per se. I think it involves so many things that you can't say environment. It's just surroundings, it's habitat. I think it's all the little things that are around you and how that is connected to something bigger. So environment is the world. It's everything in it, everything you can see, feel, touch. So it's the surroundings and the habitats, and these habitats belong or form part of a bigger habitat, and it's just a chain that is connecting every element in the world, and at the end it's one thing, what we call Earth.
Once I overcame my professional crisis, I found myself facing another crisis, but this time an environmental one. The foundation of this crisis underlies on the lack of coherence between knowledge and action, and an environmental system which is interrelated and interdependent, and where humanity is just one component among others, such as flora, fauna, soil, surface and underground water, the atmosphere and solar radiation. The dominant developing model, which is highly extractivist, productivist and consumerist, is dissociated from our planet's limitations. It is an economic system that places the human being in the center and which does not take into account that this system depends on the well-being of nature as the primary source of goods and environmental services. A dynamic balance which is necessary to our lives is being broken. An unlimited economic growth, a lineal and rising thought and action does not go hand in hand with nature's cycles, time and limits. We all live in a hurry, in a frenetic race that does not have a clear goal apart from being competitive and productive. The idea of growing, moving forward and making progress is central, but the question is, How can we achieve this? And how far are we willing to go? Through my academic and professional experience in the environmental science, I've been faced with the same contradictions to what we suggest as an alternative to the system we all are part of. It is a huge challenge to take full responsibility for this condition and to put into practice the necessary changes. The same happens in other levels beyond the personal ones, such as the community, private and governmental. The decisions we take need to be nourished by an integral approach that will make emphasis on solidarity and cooperation instead of individualism and competition. At the beginning of 2013, I began a new and enriching experience. I had the opportunity of applying and being given by the federal German government the possibility of being part of an international postgraduate course on environmental management in CIPSEM under the framework of Technical University Dresden.
Well, CIPSEM, the Center for International Postgraduate Studies of Environmental Management here at Technische Universität Dresden in Germany, was founded or started its program in 1977, so 36 years from now. Since then, we have conducted almost 100 courses with more than 1,800 participants from about 135 countries all over the globe. And we are very successfully continuing this program with the substantial support of the Federal Ministry of Environment, Nature Conservation and Nuclear Safety in Berlin and Technische Universität Dresden. CIPSEM organizes and designs its programs in close collaboration with the United Nations Environmental Program, UNEP, and the UNESCO, the Federal Ministry for the Environment, the Federal Environmental Agency. And our courses are developed in close collaboration with the Technical University here in Dresden, with the professors. We have a curriculum committee, and we are designing the programs in a way fitting to the target group, which are the experts from developing and emerging countries. One of the success factors is that the program is relatively flexible, so we are not fixed into a master's program, we are a training program. We are focusing on knowledge transfer for administrations, for multiplicators in the respective countries, exchanging among the regions, and this helps a lot to keep our program running.
Yes, I'd like to comment on this course. I'm actually teaching in this course for 15 years. I have extremely good experience with this course regarding the commitment of the people, and this is due to the structure of the course. Taking into account that we have typically 20 people from 20 countries here, and these are not students in their home countries, these are people already in a responsible position. So they know why they are here, and they want to learn something, and they want to develop something together. And for me, this is one of the very good multiplication effects we can achieve from here within Germany in other regions of the world with regard to capacity development. So it's not about educating our students and trying to motivate them to go somewhere. It's about people who come from their countries to Germany, not to stay here, but to somehow jointly develop something together and then go back home and implement something they have learned here. And I think there is also a very important atmospheric issue about this. When I see in the first week the people coming together from all the regions of the world, they are a bit unsure whether this was a good decision to come here, and then when I look at them at the end of the course, they have become a unity, they have become friends, and having also a good mood and typically good humor and a good atmosphere. So I think this is one of the best courses we offer from TU Dresden.
Facilitators within the program are 60-70% professors from our university, but we are collaborating as well with the authorities, with administrations, with the industry in the region, with colleagues from neighboring countries, with national authorities, multinational organizations. The idea is to bring back the participants to the state of the art. Typically they are 5, 10, 15 years in their profession already, so away from university, so to update their knowledge a little bit. Then we are talking about how the knowledge from the university, from research institutions, is implemented in society here in Germany. We are getting examples from developing countries by collaborating with alumni. We are inviting former participants who became professors now or working in ministries or administrations. So giving also the actual candidates a chance of exchanging experiences, also exchanging experiences among each other. They are coming from, or you are coming from, all regions in the world, and you find that you are not so different, that there are similarities between the regions, that the problems but also the success stories have certain similarities. Our course, our 6-month course on integrated environmental management, consists of several modules. So environmental management covers, in our sense, the water management, nature conservation, waste management, energy issues, forestry issues, agriculture, but also legal aspects, economic aspects of environmental management. And, well, of course, we have to start with lectures. Our professors come to class, you sit together there, but then you also want to see how it works in the field. We are working here with the authorities, we are working with the institutions in Germany. You're going to visit the Czech Republic, for instance, for an excursion on ecological landscape planning. You're visiting mining areas, you're visiting protected areas of different types. We are going into the regional industries, we are visiting farms, and so on and so forth. And there you can exchange with those people who have to implement the nice knowledge we are producing here at the universities or developing in our ministries with legal documents.
During the 6 months that the course lasted, we dealt with different environmental issues conducted in English and which were tackled in different ways, such as lectures, debates, country reports, role plays, simulations, games, case studies, workshops, seminars, and multiple field trips and excursions to different places and institutions in Germany and in neighboring countries. It was an intense, dynamic, and participative design for the course, similar to the environment which is built upon the interactions between culture and nature.
The Kyrgyz Republic.
Federal Democratic Republic of Ethiopia.
Honduras.
Iraq.
Argentina.
Ghana.
Kingdom of Cambodia.
India.
China.
Egypt.
Rwanda.
Jordan.
Cooperative Republic of Guyana.
Republic of Tanzania.
Paraguay.
Lebanon. Colombia. Venezuela.
The Seychelles Islands.
Honduras.
Syria.
Islamic Republic of Pakistan.
Argentina.
Apart from all of these opportunities to exchange knowledge and experiences, it is important to point out the cultural diversity of the course that, just as biodiversity, is related to life and beauty. Keeping diversity is important not only for its intrinsic value, but also for the different answers, perspectives, and ways to live which can be known or discovered, and from which we can learn and nurture ourselves. The complex and diverse systems are more stable and can adapt better to changes.
My expectations are to be able to gain not only knowledge with regard to technical aspects related to environmental management, but also to come to learn about other and different cultures of mine, because we are 21 participants from all over the world. So I find it interesting to be able to know people with different traditions, customs, and different point of views in order to be able to learn from them, from their experiences. and also to be able to share my experiences with them.
Since we are almost 19 countries which are participating in this course, and we have similar situations. We are facing the problem of poverty, we are facing the problem of loss of forest, loss of biodiversity, and at the same time we want to grow. So these things with our sharing experiences, what kind of laws, what kind of attitude of people we have, and I think this provides me a lot of alternatives which are possible, because in some countries I find that they are very good in protecting their biodiversity, others are good at doing waste management, some are good in implementing laws. So of course I will understand the socio-economic aspects of it, political aspects of it, and possibly the more alternatives for me to take back home. So in a nutshell, I would say that I'm here to know the state of art and share experiences.
One of the biggest threats to cultural and biological diversity is the land use change, which does not adjust to an environmental planning. For example, the construction of a motorway fragments urban and natural spaces. Therefore, different measures to compensate and mitigate these negative impacts on the population and the ecosystem should be considered. Satellite images and the Geographic Information System, GIS, permit an analysis and an integration of information for planning and decision making.
Remote sensing is a very important tool, and for some questions the only one you can use if you want to monitor changes of land surfaces and land units like agriculture changes, vegetation changes, even in the field of desertification, monitoring, and also quantification of changes, increase or decrease of agriculture. But you should add also other information sources. This is very important. Literature, old literature, maps, and maybe also knowledge, if this is possible to speak directly with people, this is very important. But for the documentation and the quantification, the only source to monitor changes of land surfaces are the remote sensing tool, because you have no, or maybe you have aerial photos, but this is also part of the remote sensing tool. Yeah. And for environmental management, also remote sensing very important, but for both questions you need also field research and the so-called ground truth analysis to understand what you see in the images. And for environmental management, you can observe all the changes, and for example, for the installation of anti-erosion measures, are they successful or are they less successful? Are they really there where people told you they should be there, and all these kind of things. So this is a very effective monitoring system, but it is not cheap.
Environmental management nurtures from the contributions made by the different technologies, the sciences, and knowledge so as to tackle environmental issues and problems. It makes no sense to adopt a reductionist stand in order not to see and assume that the environment is inherently complex. For this reason, even at the academic, private, or public level, the environment should not be thought as one more element to consider, but as a dimension that goes through and that can be the axis for all the other dimensions.
A lot of sectors, a lot of conflict of interest in, you have to manage everything together to keep the environment, and it's very difficult, but it's also very easy if we understand the meaning of environment or environmental management, it will be easy.
The challenge of this international postgraduate course and the environmental dimension in general is to establish an integrating approach in all politics, decisions and planning, taking into account that it is important for the technical knowledge to be translated into an accessible language for all the social actors, especially for the decision makers. Theory sounds very attractive, however, putting it into practice, not only in this course but in general, brings about the difficulty to transcend the sectorial order historically established in governmental and non-governmental institutions as well as to translate and democratize the technical information. It is a matter of political willingness, private compromise, and citizen participation. The fundamental necessity to challenge the consumerist and productivist patterns and propose cycles instead of flows, learning from nature which, for example, does not generate waste, not only coincides with a fragile world and limited resources, but also with an interdependent world in which we have to coexist so as to survive. Closing the loop is a tendency in which many areas are progressing. It is a blessing that the paths of life can be a journey and not a race, and that they can be winding and not straight, with landscapes and diverse company, without a finishing line, a final destination, but a process to go through, like the very concept of sustainability and the associated environmental management.
I'm with the course for more than 20 years now, and in the meantime it has developed in a very nice way. So the first years were the years in the GDR, and after the wall came down and after the reunification of Germany, it was a big success throughout the whole world to give courses in environmental management for developing and emerging countries. The most important thing for me is it's about people, because they are coming from all kinds of backgrounds, different education, different religion, different culture, different languages, different thinking, way of thinking, different food and everything what belongs to that. So we try to give here an international environment for people who come from all over the world. So, and when they return to their countries, they take something back to their countries. They come as an ambassador for their specific country. But when they return, they are an ambassador for German environmental policy and things they learned here. And furthermore, there is a possibility to network. And between each other, there's an alumni network so that they can exchange their experience and work on things that are relevant for their projects. Either they are in South America, or in Africa, or in Asia. Sometimes people work in the same field and have similar problems. So they can interact between each other and solve problems in this way. Furthermore, it is a good opportunity to learn something about, well, another approach from other people within the courses, I mean the participants. They have the chance to develop their intercultural legs, let me say it like this. So when they return, they have widened their horizon and they can interact in another way because they learned to get along with each other. And so it is good for their country to have people in these countries who have learned about things they haven't had the chance to see and to develop and to learn in their own countries.
My path came across with that of CIPSEMs and those who were part of the course. Together, we had many experiences that have made this last 6 months a very valuable life experience. All the efforts made and shared, like preparing this final paper, or going through one of the longest and gloomiest winters in the history of Germany, have borne their fruits and mean new opportunities and horizons. Thank you.
foremost about my country is about my family. But after that, I miss sunny days, because since we were here, we've only had 5 sunny days in a month and a half. And I'm used to being able to go out and feel the sun and the warmth. And also, I miss the food. We have really, really good typical foods, which I'm used to. So those would be the things I miss.
We start doing those things, we start thinking in a limited way, that our resources are limited, then I think the acceptance of the alternative strategies which are less damaging will be more, because right now I don't think for example, if I want a car, that's a sign of progress. If I want 10 cars, I'm more wealthy. But then if I start understanding that these resources are limited, fossil fuel as well as all the energy going into it, then maybe if I take a bicycle, I will be considered wealthier and more enlightened and better off. So I think that is where if you start measuring the damages and we factor into our indices, those growth parameters, then I think the possible solution we may find.
One of the ways to get out of this, I think, would be joint forces all together, nations, people. It sounds very cliche saying it starts with a small change, but it's the truth. Starting in your own home, starting doing little things to save, you know, resources, to save the planet, because that is reality. What we are going to face is a way to preserve what we already have. So I would say one of the strategies out would be working all together with the focus of having the wealth of everyone in an equal way, not nations having more than others, although it's impossible to say we'll have an equal lifestyle, but you can always do more and you can always help in ways that would improve drastically, you know, the development of other nations in a sustainable way. Those nations that are the ones that have the largest natural assets that the world accounts with today. So it's all about, you know, thinking in a global way, humanity per se, the preservance of our human nature, of our natural environment.
Well, one of the main objectives of all kind of training programs is the building of capacity in a certain field, here environmental management. It is important to see the networking aspect. We are still in contact with approximately half or a little bit more of our 1,800 alumni. Networking and capacity building are definitely the key aspect of sustainable development in developing countries nowadays. We have to see the development also of development aid programs. We are not focusing on pure project-based support in developing countries, but we have to initiate the development and the capacity building process in developing countries. So where we see a very strong aspect of our program is the building of knowledge, the building of links between Germany and the countries. We have strong partners already all over the world, and this is one of the success factors also of our program, as I see. You always have to ask, well, what is the part we can contribute to such a success, or to what is the success indicator of training, of education? And of course, it's very difficult to answer that, yeah? Because whether a good candidate will become better through our program or whether he will contribute in a better way to the development of his country with or without our program, we cannot really measure. But at least we are trying to do our best to partner in this process and to give you the opportunities to develop your own career, your own country, for the betterment of our nature.
This is my first documentary with a short period of time to do it and no previous experience, but with a lot of enthusiasm, and it is part of my practical proposal and the final paper, which represents the ending of the course and my return to Argentina. Far behind are now those days of anxiety over an uncertain profession. However, I am aware of the fact that doors are still opening and that nothing, or almost nothing, is definitive. In the meantime, I have found in documentaries a powerful communication tool to exchange successful experiences to foster international cooperation. Technical and specific knowledge are certainly of great importance. However, it is essential not to lose sight of the bigger picture. Relational thinking does not tend to be encouraged, while the person who establishes relations is able to question and transform reality. Therefore, it is necessary to develop an approach that can be compatible with the environmental complexity, with interaction and interdependence, without which an understanding and an integral environmental management would not be possible.